To me, it, while important, especially considering Joe Biden's position on guns, he lied on a gun application. That, to me, is just a way to try and appease the public, because they've been exposed as trying to give a sweetheart deal to Hunter. But when you have Joe Biden promising as a candidate and a president over and over again that he never had conversations with his brother, with Hunter, or anybody about foreign business deals, and then Devin Archer testifies that, in fact, he was privy to at least 20 calls where Joe called in. Then we know about the Dubai call with Burisma executives just, what, 4 or 5 days before Joe went to Ukraine and leveraged $1 billion. Then you look at the sheer amount of money that the Biden family is getting, funneled through shell corporations, 9 Biden family members identified as being recipients. No experience at all that would warrant this type of payment, except their connection to Joe. And then the very specific action of firing the prosecutor. To me, I feel we're looking at a real bribery, money laundering, scandal. These are allegations. And it seems that David Weiss has no intention of looking into it.
Well, it doesn't take much of an effort to reach the obvious conclusion. You know, they're lying. I mean, the president lied when he ran for office. He said he didn't know about these business dealings. Hunter Biden's close associate said that's patently false. Other witnesses have said they spoke to President Biden about the business dealings. These issues were raised not only with the SEC, but the State Department raised Hunter Biden's dealings. Say it undermined the efforts to deal with corruption in the Ukraine. So it's not particularly complex. And that's part of what's so shocking here, is the effort by people in government and by the media to not see what's happening. It's like, you know, you used to have a Houdini would make an entire elephant disappear from a stage. Well, the elephant never left the stage, but Houdini knew that the audience really wanted it to disappear. And that's what has happened in Washington. They want the elephant to disappear, and it did. And the Bidens really take credit for the magic trick of the century. They made an obvious scandal disappear in front of an audience of millions.
Well, where does this go from here? Because anybody with eyes to see can see exactly what happened here. And we're talking about tens of millions of dollars, Jonathan. We're talking about direct actions taken as vice president and the consequence, the result of which is the enrichment of the vice president's family. And it wasn't just one country. It was some of our top geopolitical foes, Jonathan. That, to me, is a clear present danger and a national security risk to the country.
Well, what's notable, Sean, is that the best argument now for an impeachment inquiry is being made by Attorney General Garland. You know, we now know that when many of us were objecting that the statute of limitations was running on some of these crimes, those same objections were being raised to Weiss and the Department of Justice inside the government. And they apparently wanted the statute of limitations to run on the most serious of those tax crimes. And now you have a stonewalling of Congress on many of these allegations of corruption. That leaves Congress with very little choice. You know, they can continue to engage in this game of chicken with the administration to see who's going to jump out first. Or they can change the game. They can start an impeachment inquiry. Because whatever Hunter Biden did or did not do, it's unlikely he's going to be punished to the full extent of the law. But in the end, that's not the main problem. The main problem is what was done to protect him from the law and what is still being done to do so.
But Jonathan,
that raises serious questions with regard to his father.
Is it? Well, that was my next question. Is it really about Hunter at that point, or is it about his father that was active and involved in making all this happen and the family benefiting because of it?
It's about his father, Sean. I mean, the fact is, you now have the White House actively involved, including creating a war room in anticipation of an impeachment inquiry. And they're actively involved in pushing this narrative. He has bootstrapped these earlier actions into his administration.
Well, all right, we're going to continue to follow this. Every detail, it's important. The country's going to wake up to this. Jonathan Turley, thank you.
Hey.